How to get data off the hard drive in a dead computer. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question. My computer died on me. I can't get it to boot up. I need to take the hard drive out and pull my files off of it. How do I retrieve the files from the hard drive in my dead computer? Thanks for any help you can give me. It's actually a pretty common scenario. Depending on what caused the computer's demise, there's a relatively good chance that you could retrieve the information off of that hard drive. Of course, if it's the drive itself that caused the failure, yeah, things get a little bit more interesting. There are several approaches to this problem. I'll start with my favorite approach, not needing to do anything at all. By far, the simplest solution to this problem is not needing to solve it. By that I mean, and you know where this is going, a good backup strategy can almost eliminate the need to recover anything from the hard drive in a dead computer. Using another computer, or after the dead computer has been repaired, restore as much as you want, potentially the entire system, from your most recent image backup. That's why I like taking image backups every day. At most, you'd be only one day out of sync with your work. Restore the last-minute changes from online services that you've been using for more or less continuous backups. I use Dropbox for this. Do your work in a Dropbox folder, remember to hit save every so often, and even if the machine dies completely, the work in progress will have been saved online. Now, unfortunately, most people don't have a comprehensive backup plan in place. There are also other reasons, like last-minute change that was important or something not yet saved online, that might require retrieving the data off of a dead machine's drive. So we'll give that a try. If you can boot the machine into safe mode, or perhaps even from an installation or rescue media, then the place to start is actually to run checkdisk/r on the drive. That will scan the disk for surface errors that can cause the disk to become inaccessible. If you can't boot at all, or if checkdisk doesn't help, and this is a traditional magnetic hard drive, it might be worth buying SpinRite to see if it can repair the drive. If it can't, you can get your money back. SpinRite boots from its own media and can attempt to both diagnose and possibly repair errors on the disk surface. If those options don't work or don't help or they're just not available, yeah, time to try something else. One of the first things I generally do in these situations is I take the hard drive out of that dead computer and purchase a USB drive enclosure. These are almost identical to an external USB drive, except there's no drive inside. You put in the drive you have out of your old machine. You do need, of course, to get the correct size enclosure for the physical size of your drive. Current drives are either usually 3.5 or 2.5 inches wide, and the enclosure, of course, has to match. SSDs come in two form factors as well, one that is physically the same as the 2.5 in a traditional hard drive, and there's this newer M.2 format, which is smaller, faster, better, whatever. There are external enclosures for those as well. Then it's a relatively simple matter of installing the drive into the new drive enclosure. Not only do you now have a way to access the drive, but it's portable. You can access your data on whatever computer you have available. After you've recovered the data you care about, that drive can have a useful second life, perhaps, as an external drive. Perhaps you can use it to create the backup strategy that might have saved you from all this in the first place. If the drive fails to work with the external enclosure, perhaps it shows up as unformatted when you connect to it, or you connect it to another computer, or it just doesn't show up at all, then, sad to say, it's probably time to consult with a technician or a data recovery service if it's important enough. Now, there's one catch that comes up from time to time. When moving a drive from system A, which had a problem, to system B, where you're trying to recover the data, you might connect it only to find that although you can see that the drive is there and has files on it, you're not allowed to see any of them. Not to worry. As long as you can log into system B with an account that has administrative privileges, you'll be able to take ownership and or change the permissions associated with the files so that you can read, copy, backup, or do whatever you like with them. This applies to any drive moved from one system to another, whether it's installed internally or externally, and regardless of the reasons for doing so. The permissions on the drive are relative to its original system, and therefore they need to be adjusted for the new system. How do I gain access to files that Windows says I don't have permission to access? Shows you how. So, bottom line, yeah, prepare for the inevitable. Hard disks die. It's a fact of life. Cynical folks would say that they tend to die at the worst possible time. The best approach is to prepare for this certainty by backing up. Nothing can protect you better. Prepare well, and when, not if, your hard disk dies, it'll be an inconvenience and not a disaster. If you don't have those backups in place, well, at least now you have a few things to try to get the data off that hard disk from your dead computer. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/4684. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.